Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Sandeep Boradia welcoming all of you on this webinar. I hope all of you and your families are safe, healthy, and at home. Small introduction about myself. I've been with ICICI Lombard for about 19 years, and I take care of the corporate business at ICICI Lombard. As we could not meet physical times, this is the first of the series of various webinars that we plan to conduct over the next few days, covering diverse topics of interest and concerns that you may have, whether it is for your asset properties, marine cargo, as well as liability risks. As we all know, the most important asset for all of us is the people. We thought that let the first, the webinar be focus only on the, the health and wellness for all our employees. So this event, which is planned for about an hour, has two segments. Okay, the first segment consists of a panel discussion. So we are going to do a discussion with the senior dignitaries.
Good afternoon, everybody. So because of a technical glitch, Sandeep Goradia is not on a video call right now, but I am taking over. And just to brief that today's webinar will have two sections. The first section will basically have a panel discussion around the COVID-19 outbreak that has happened and what are the challenges before us and what are the steps that as a company ICICI Lombard is taking. And in the second section, we will call Dr. Om Srivastava, who is a very renowned doctor in Harkishan Das Hospital, to talk about the current crisis and the questions that you people have posed offline with us. There we will pose, we'll pose at him. So let me start by introducing our panel. Before that, let me introduce myself. My name is Alok Agarwal. I am Executive Director at ICICI Lombard, and I look after the wholesale portfolio of ICICI Lombard. And I'm very glad to be present in this first in the series of wellness seminar. Now we have on screen Amitabh Jain. Amitabh Jain is our Head of Underwriting for Health and Wellness, Head of Underwriting and Claims. And he will be a part of the panel. We also have Mr. Sanjay Datta. He is the head of the risk for the entire ICICI Lombard, all products, head of risk, underwriting, claims, and a very senior person in our amidst us, who has been with us right from the beginning in ICICI Lombard. And basically, as Sandeep is not there, we will be doing the moderation will be done by me itself. So let me start by talking about one thing at this panel, is what is the impact that we will have on this basically effect of COVID-19 on the economy. I will give my views for the next few minutes. What I feel is that the impact of the economy will be basically, there are people who are talking about V-shaped recovery, the people are talking about U-shaped recovery, some people are talking about L-shaped recovery. In my opinion, there are some sectors which are definitely getting impacted because of this COVID-19, which we are very well aware of. But one significant factor that we have to understand is that India is not as export-intensive country as many other countries. So look at China, which is hugely export-led country, or you look at Europe, which are itself where there are so many countries in Western Europe which are very small, as large as one of Indian states. They are also very hugely export-oriented sectors. My take on this is the countries which have low export orientation, plus those countries which have a huge domestic population, they will have basically impact. They will have less impact. So India falls into that category. Now, this is a survey done by FICCI, and when we have when FICCI has asked various people what is the business impact forecast, then various people have talked about 75% of the people have talked about that there will be reduction in manpower. 70% people have talked about degrowth in sales. 61% have said that the expansion plans will be deferred. And 60% have said fundraising plans will be deferred, and 34% have said impact on exports will be there. So my personal belief is that as far as this impact of COVID is concerned, it will be a U-shaped recovery. It might so happen if the government intervention is fast and quick, then the base of the U will be smaller. And if it is not so, maybe the base of U will be slightly become larger. But India will definitely bounce back because of its large domestic population, large domestic market, less export orientation, less dependence on various countries for supply chain. There are certain products which have a supply chain impact, but those are limited products. There are some industries like pharma and FMCG and certain computer-related IT and ITS-related industries, which will have a very minimal impact going forward. So I would now ask Amitabh to share his views.
Thanks, Alok. As rightly pointed out by you, we are facing a double impact of both a medical crisis as well as an economic crisis. And to ensure that in such times we still service our customers and our all our members, we ensured that from the month of March, sometime in second week of March, we started preparing for a business continuity plan, which ensured that we were more or less ready for the onslaught that we were about to face once the lockdown was announced. And what we did is that we basically put in two major initiatives in place. One was our own preparedness in terms of our internal processes and all the changes to be done so that our people can work from home. So we had our business continuity plan, which got activated, and we ensured that 85% of our workforce was enabled to work from home. They were provided wherever we didn't have laptops, etc. They were procured in record time and provided to this team. And this team ensured that we started processing claims through all our digital and other initiatives that we have put in place over a period of time, to ensure that whatever claims that were coming to us, whatever service requests that were coming to us, could still be handled. To ensure that all our customers were not put to any kind of problem, we provided the e-cashless mode to all our hospitals' networks, as well as the e-claims for their hospital reimbursements to be done. And on an average, we've been, both approving the cashless requests as well as the discharge request within, a period of about 80 minutes. We also ensured that our customers are not put into any trouble by enabling what we call a scan now document later, saying that you can scan your documents, send it to us, we'll pay off your claim, and then we will collect the documents later. We also opened an in our I'll Take Care app, which we'll talk about later, basically an option to even raise claims request from the app. We also created a helpline for COVID-19 health assistance. Some of these things we will discuss when we discuss the app.
So now I will ask Sanjay Datta to share his views.
Thank you, Alok, and thank you for joining us on this webinar. It's an absolute pleasure in these times to be able to communicate through these kind of tools to everyone. As both Alok and Amitabh have talked about, not only what's happening on the economy and what we are taking in terms of steps for preparing ourselves and being able to deliver during these times. One key piece of statistics I would like to start with in terms of my view, global financial crisis 2008 happened, correct? And there was a big concern during that time, if any one of you remember, that some big insurers or reinsurers went through certain big turbulence. AIG Swiss Re was one of those things. Of course, nothing related to insurance operations. It was more to do with their financial investments, which went into trouble. But having said that, I just wanted to give you a small piece of statistic, which is important in these times. In Indian market at that point, in 2008, the general insurance market was $7.5 billion. Chinese market, if you just look at BRICS, Brazil, Russia, India, China, and look at how they perform for the next 2 years. And exactly to, look at Alok's point, I would just like to give the data point. The Indian market, by 2010, by 2011, had grown by 6.3%. Correct. And the initial first year it was 2.5, then it grew by 6.3. Similar with Brazil, but they stayed at 4%. Russia actually went into decline. Their market contracted. So, China, of course, expanded. They expanded very fast, and they maintained 7.8 versus India 6.3. But the basic point I would like to make here is because this is an underpenetrated insurance market, and it is linked to the growth of, general insurance market is always linked to the growth of the, economy. So, given that perspective, I think, I am hopeful, like in this, 2008 crisis, the Indian economy, and if the Indian economy is able to bounce back, there is precedence in terms of correlation with the general insurance market, both here in China, that we would be able to grow. And that's a very, very positive sign, which I would like to put out for us. It's important for us at this point of time to, not only look at, the issues around health, which is very, very important from a life perspective. How do we secure ourselves, our employees, and everyone, in terms of the new normal, in terms of social distancing and all of that. But the more important point is for us to be able to look ahead and be able to shape ourselves for the future. And for that, I think a lot of the enablers have already started taking place in the ecosystem. We were not able to make this transition to being able to operate from our offices and all that, had not technology and a lot of our insurtech investments not taken off. So we were able to use a lot of automation processes, maybe a little bit of AI, also machine learning, to be able to come to a point where we were able to start deploying all of it, much more rapid scale, which we had to do during this, scale. But in all of this, one of the most important feature is that the customers, as in all of you who are able to link into us, should also be able to use our processes and be able to operate well. We are here to give you, support both from a risk management perspective. It's important that we manage the risk very well, both on the insurer, you know, the risks which are related to this situation, you know, along with other catastrophic risks. And also the other part where we would also be like to make sure that on this front, you do not have additional shocks. You know, you would not like, you know, at this point to suffer a risk which comes, you know, like a flood or a thing, you know, during this time when you are trying to revive yourself. That's what we insurers are. So when you try to revive yourself economically, we will have to make sure that on the other catastrophic risks, you are covered, and we would like to help you prevent those risks. Start up, if you're, you know, close your factory, start up well, and, you know, things like that.
So taking it forward, one point I wanted to add. Some people are talking about this oil prices going down and the impact on India. So as of now, the revenue collected by the government has also come down because of the oil consumption coming down. And even under the current situation, the oil production in India is so small that India is forced to import even today. When the demand has come down significantly to almost 15 to 20% of what it used to be. So going forward now, I want to introduce one thing to you. So we had, before COVID-19 was heard of, and maybe a year and a half back, we had launched an app called IL-TakeCare. This app was basically designed for convenience of yours, so that everything could be done with the convenience of your laptop or your mobile phone or your iPad, whatever handheld device that you may have. And there are various features in IL-TakeCare app, but one thing that we focused very heavily on was the teleconsulting. And this teleconsulting today has become a buzzword. I know, for example, that there are many hospitals where OPD is not working, and the doctors are giving consultations from home. So teleconsulting has become a very important feature of today's medical world. And in our IL-TakeCare app, teleconsulting has been enabled, and there are some very famous doctors which are part of the teleconsulting. And in today's era, this can be a very big boon. The second most used thing, in my opinion, is the second opinion thing. People are aware that in a normal course, people are sometimes suggested surgeries and other things, which they are not so sure whether they should go ahead or not. And they generally go and ask their relatives, their family doctors, etc. We have basically provided this second opinion facility by which people can go and take second opinion from renowned doctors both in India and abroad. And this second opinion facility has been given to all people. To talk about the details of the IL-TakeCare app, I would now request Amitabh Jain to join in and take us forward.
Yeah, so as rightly pointed out by Alok, you know, this is one app that we've created, which is like a one-stop solution for all your insurance and wellness needs. You know, the IL-TakeCare app was conceptualized about 1.5 years back, and we started working on it from that time. And it's just that, you know, at this point in time, it's become such a handy feature available with all our customers that in a time when we want to have zero contact, we don't want to venture out of our homes, we don't want to, you know, take that risk of going to an OPD clinic or to a doctor, some of these services can become very, very handy. Just to introduce the app, you know, the IL-TakeCare app has lots of features, but to begin with, it is once you have a policy with us, you are a group policy holder under an employer. As an employee, you get all your policy related details and your e-cards right on the app. And then you can even check all your policy features. You can request for addition of members. Any edits that you want to do on the e-card, etc., can also be done from the app itself. And you can raise modification requests as well, which can be done directly by the company in consultation with your HR. So that's related to the policy. Now, coming to the network and the wellness services, we have a whole host of features. where we can actually display all our network hospitals on the touch of a button. We can, you know, connect you to a doctor for teleconsultation. You can lodge your claims, both cashless as well as reimbursements. We have an OPD service where we have a meet a doctor section where you can actually schedule an appointment with a doctor. You can avail of cashless medicines. You can avail of cashless, you know, features on pharma, on getting yourself checked at any, you know, diagnostic center. So whole lot of features there, but particularly as Alok mentioned, we have this feature called Hello Doctor, which is a teleconsultation feature. At the touch of this icon, you know, you get an option for you to say that whether you want to receive a call from a doctor. And if you say yes, within a few minutes, an MBBS doctor will get in touch with you and check for your conditions. And all the over-the-counter drugs that are there can be prescribed by this doctor. In case you have a situation or a condition where something severe is diagnosed by the doctor, then only they will ask you to, you know, kind of go for a physical consultation. So this ensures that you have a zero contact situation where you can easily avail of a qualified doctor sitting at your homes, wherever you are, you know, without venturing out. The services of a doctor over a phone call, and it's very, very seamless. This comes to all our policy holders, and it is part of the policy wherever you have purchased the particular cover. But even if you have not, during these times of COVID, we've enabled two calls which are coming absolutely free to all the members who have our policies. So that's something that we've taken as an initiative, so that even if you didn't avail of this feature, you get it at the, you know, sitting at your home, and you are able to avail of this teleconsult feature. Next, I would like to talk about the COVID-19 section that we quickly created in the app, just to ensure that you can get, you know, yourself checked for any kind of symptoms. So there is a bot-enabled COVID risk checker that we have put that in place by answering a few questions that are you know, at the back end managed through an AI bot. Your particular condition can be diagnosed as a severe or a high risk, medium risk or a low risk. And basis that, you can again take a call of either going for a teleconsult or a physical consultation, or as per the ICMR guidelines, get in touch with a government approved, you know, facility. Also, we put an information board there, which directly connects you to authentic information about the hospitals that are servicing COVID patients, the labs that are available, and whole lot of other information. And then we also created a blog section where, you know, when you are at home, you have these issues about managing your physical fitness, about your stress, about the nutrition, etc. So you get a lot of articles over there, and we keep updating that. So that's the COVID section that we created. And if you go forward, we have the section on what we created as an health assistance page within the app. So you can choose whatever condition you are having, write it to us in case you don't want to do a teleconsultation, or you're already consulted a doctor on your own and you want a second opinion, you want to fix some appointment, you want to check on a particular, you know, facility, whether COVID is being serviced there or not, even for other information on any hospitals. All of that is again available through this particular feature on the app, where you put these requests and, you know, within half an hour to 1 hour, you will get someone reaching back to you and checking your specific issue and then talking to you and trying to solve whatever problem you're having. So that's the health assistance feature. And finally, if you look at the OPD section, which I talked about earlier, that's the meet a doctor section, where we have created all the three aspects of doctor consultation, pharmacy, diagnostics, and health checkup, all everything to do with your consultation requirements with a doctor. And the beauty of this is that this all is available through a cashless system where you're not required to pay anything. You've taken this cover, everything is done absolutely cashless and you know, with the touch of a button. So those are the main features that we wanted to talk about. And this is a time when, you know, you can actually try these things out wherever you have a problem, and you can actually sit at home and avail all of this.
So thank you, Amitabh. Now I will request Sanjay to talk about which are the new products that we have introduced which are specific for COVID, and what are the options that we have for our customers and patrons.
Thanks, Alok. The presentation comes. As the presentation comes, I'd like to, you know, there are two areas. Want to clarify one particular thing. All of our normal, health indemnity policies are meant to cover COVID-19. So which basically means hospitalization or quarantining in a hospital. So wherever, you know, such requirements are there, COVID-19 treatment, is covered, through the reimbursement route or through the cashless route. Having said that, there are, two specific initiatives we took, to be able to provide, coverage for COVID-19 as a standalone kind of risk, where we said that the coverage would trigger someone being detected with COVID-19. That was one part. The other part was also looking at devising certain customized products for people who would like to give their coverages for their workers, maybe on an reimbursement basis or indemnity basis. And last but not the least, there has been a kind of industry-wide cover which is becoming a cover which has just been launched, which will cover COVID-19 on a much more broader basis, with some insurance from 1 lakh to 5 lakh. Just to now come back to the specifics of each product, I would like to start with the benefit product. So what you've devised this product for is for situations where if you are detected with COVID-19, then you get a straight payout on detection. The detection is based on a test which gets, conducted by the testing processes which the government has mandated. And after 14 days from availing a cover, just after 14 days, if you're detected, then you get a payout immediately which goes to your account, to whoever has been, given this, kind of cover. Of course, we are bundling it with what Amitabh talked about, teleconsult and maybe some ambulance assistance in case you need to, go to a hospital. The whole idea of this entire cover is to that if you are COVID-19, you have mild symptoms, you need to be quarantined at home. You do undertake a lot of treatment at home, for which you need coverage. And so this is one immediate kind of coverage which we are able to give to corporates or partners who work with us to be able to give it to their, kind of customers or maybe to their employees. That is one part. A similar kind of approach is being, made for a COVID-only product for on a reimbursement basis. And now coming to the whole issue of workers getting, covered for this particular product, we are building a lot of, over-the-counter kind of products where such coverage is available to employees of, small companies which do not have such coverage. They were either covered by ESIC or were not covered at all. Workers' compensation does not, kind of come to effect in these kind of situations. So in this sort of situation, we have devised small covers which, it can be given to workers where the workers come back to work, and the government has mandated that when you bring your workers back to work, you need to have medical coverage for such workers. And last but not the least, the whole idea was to have a comprehensive product also, which takes care of not only COVID-19 patients, but COVID-suspect patients. So not everyone who's suspected becomes a COVID-19 patient. And hence, you may have comorbidities, you may have other kinds of illnesses, may or may not, come out of COVID-19. But, you're not sure, you get admitted with similar symptoms, then it's turned up, it turns out it's something else. This product, okay, they're just now launched, would cover, workers or other customers for between 1 and 5 lakhs. And the whole idea is to be able to, you know, give a product which is kind of affordable, and we have one of the most affordable products in the market. But this product, you know, you can continue as your regular product once COVID-19 dies down. You can, you know, use it for all your other conferences. That's in short a bouquet of products which we have decided to kind of launch around COVID-19. You know, to be honest, these are products which we have launched at this particular point of time with a certain, you know, idea of trying to build awareness around not only helping on the COVID-19 situation, but also building awareness around health insurance and how it can help us to tide over such situations where we have a market which has been very, very underpenetrated in terms of health insurance coverage.
So now it's 4 o'clock, and I believe Dr. Om Srivastava should have joined by this time. So we would invite Dr. Om Srivastava, who is a very senior doctor from Harkishan Das Hospital, to share his thoughts. I hope he is on live.
Yes, sir, he's online now.
Yeah. So we can bring him online to share his thoughts.
Yeah. Should I on the video?
Yeah. You can start, sir.
Okay. Well, good afternoon, everybody. As already been discussed, I was actually just following the last couple of slides with a lot of interest. I have been given a set of questions, and I'm going to start with that. Can you please tell us?
Your face is half visible. Can you tilt the screen? Now it's better. Now you can start.
The first question is how this is different from other pandemics. Well, it is different in many ways in that this is a novel coronavirus. Okay, we know about the coronavirus, but this virus we have known only for the last, well, less than 4 months. Okay, so in that we are probably only learning about it every day. Every day there is more and more evidence. What we knew in the month of January is different to what we know today, and what we know today is probably going to be different from what we'll know in another about 3 or 4 months' time. So every day there is something new that is coming up. This virus is in its own nature, it's a little sly. And I'll tell you why, because this virus is going to be coming in our lives in multiple waves. We're going through the first wave right now. We're probably going to be having a second wave, or even maybe a third wave or a fourth wave. That is the one biggest way in the way it is different. Because if you look at the other infections that this virus has had, the coronavirus has had, that has been the SARS epidemic or the MERV epidemic. The current epidemic is different to all of those epidemics. So it is different, and we still don't know as to how different it's going to be in the weeks or the months to come. So I think that it's important to keep your eye open about what might happen from here in the future, and not be complacent that, look, the numbers in any part of the world are getting better, or stabilizing, or the infection rate is getting lesser. I think complacency is going to be the biggest problem in understanding how this virus is going to function. What are the common mistakes that people are doing because of which this is spreading? So the, you know, difficult as it may be, the social distancing is something that we need to do. We need to keep ourselves in a state of lockdown for as long as possible, which is something that we are not doing, that we ought to be doing a little bit more. I know that there are multiple problems with the logistics of social distancing, but that is important. That is one. The second thing is you need to keep your hands as clean as possible for as long as possible. You need to wash your hands as many times. If it is 200 times a day, you need to do it 200 times a day. You must remember that every person that you're getting in touch with is a potential COVID positive patient, and every surface that you're touching is a potential COVID infected surface, or it's a surface where the virus exists. So whether it's a table, whether it's a doorknob, whether it's a lift button, the mobile button, all of those things are potential sources of infection. You need to decontaminate yourself and sterilize your hands and clean those surfaces as much as possible. One of the other strategies that are being used is that you can use, so in some of the corporate houses that I've been asked to comment on, we are using sprays of something called sodium hypochlorite. The hypochlorite is something that will sterilize a surface for at least 3 or 4 hours time, and that is sufficient for you to keep doing that many, you know, 3 or 4 times a day, 5 times, 6 times a day. So these are the two measures that that can be used in corporate houses like yours, and that will help. These are probably the two biggest mistakes that people are making in today's times. There are news about medicines which are positively affecting COVID patients. Is there information from, is this true universally? If so, why is recovery not increasing? Okay, so that's an interesting question. There are medicines that are being worked around the universe, the globe, not the universe, the planet. A lot of them have promise. Some of them are on the threshold of being approved for treatment. Some of them are still in the state of being, you know, looked upon as being very, very potentially good medications. We don't have a cure at this time. We should have it, you know, as early as maybe, who knows. But there is so much being done all over the globe to find a cure that something should be happening very soon. Yeah. Only thing is, it needs to be validated. It needs to be scientifically proven and then put up as treatment. So we are not yet there. We are not yet there, but hopefully we should be there very soon. Okay. What is your opinion about vaccines and which are the ones that are being developed? Is that too little and too late? Well, it's never too late, right? It's never too late. It is, you've got to believe that what can be done, the best can be done at this time is being done. So it's never going to be too little or too late. When you see that there is a problem, you have to marshal your resources into finding what is the best thing that can be done in this kind of a state. So I think that vaccine development, a vaccine that might come on your table is still at least not before January of next year. If that, January of next year is probably going to be the earliest time that it will be on your table. The Oxford Medical School and University is starting clinical trials as of today, as we speak. So that's good news. There may be other vaccines that may be useful, especially the diphtheria vaccine that may have, the BCG vaccine that may have some merit, the polio vaccine that may have some merit. So we don't know as yet, that's being evaluated. That's a process, and we will know as soon as it is ready to be used. We will know. So hopefully another about 8-10 months time, that's going to be the earliest time for a vaccine to be available. What message do you want to give? I think that you need to realize that this is not an infection that is going away in 2 months or 1 month. Even if the lockdown gets relaxed, this is now going to be a way of life for all of us, all over the globe, all over the planet. I think it's important to realize that. It's important to understand that this is actually a situation that we have brought upon ourselves, and that we need to be careful that these mistakes are not repeated. We should not repeat these mistakes. We should be able to practice social distancing and prevent those abuses of the environment that we have been doing so far. If we learn our lesson at this time, then that's the best outcome of the situation. Otherwise, we'll probably have this kind of situation happening to us all the time. I don't want to end this on a pessimistic note, but that's a harsh reality, and that we need to talk about this amongst ourselves and change the way we function. I don't think there's anything to be pessimistic about this kind of situation. It is an epidemic. It's a pandemic. You've got to learn to understand how to live with it. You've got to learn to understand what best you can do as an individual, as an organization, as a community, as a country, and do that to the best of your ability. And that some good will come out of this in the very foreseeable future. I want to thank you for your time, and I wish you all the best. If there is a question, I'm quite happy to take it now. Yeah, but I'm going to tell them I'm done.
Yeah, thank you, sir, for sharing your views. We are not taking questions online because it will create some kind of a confusion. So thank you for your participating in this. Thank you, sir, for participating in this very interesting talk and all the questions that you have taken. So in case we have any questions, we will consult offline or in the next seminar that we hold. Thank you, sir, for participating.
Thank you.
Yep. Thank you, sir. Yeah.
So there are one or two things that I wanted to talk about before we close today. So, one thing that we wanted to talk about was about the mental health issues. So the one of the side effect I would say of all this lockdown and people being holed up in their homes is that there have been some mental health issues with people and what are the ways in which these mental health issues have been talked about? So I want to say is that our teleconsult feature will also help us to contact the psychiatrists and psychologists. And I would ask Amitabh to elaborate slightly more about this facility, about the mental health issues.
Yeah, so it's our endeavor that, you know, going forward, we'll also be enabling the teleconsult feature for, you know, super specialization kind of issues where, you know, you need super specialists and also for mental and psychological kind of situations. So while right now we have a panel where the MBBS doctors are available, but we are also working on the background to see that you know, these kind of services can also be provided to our customers. So that, right, as rightly pointed out by you, being at home continuously and this continuous kind of stress that is building up because of the uncertainty, because of the issues that are happening, obviously it is leading to some amount of mental concerns in various households and with various people, and we are fully aware of that. We understand that this is also something which needs to be addressed, and we will definitely be working to provide a solution in that space.
So one more thing that came to my notice in the last 15-20 days is that government Ministry of Home Affairs has come up with a circular asking that all workers need to be insured. Now, Sanjay, I want to ask you one question. Is that this circular, should they cover, is the ESIC cover enough, or should they go and have a comprehensive health cover, which we have been anyway giving?
So, yeah, you know, the ESIC cover has certain limitations. It's meant to take care of, you know, workers who are mostly, you know, tuned to getting a lot of on the job, more, you know, work related ailments tended to. So, you know, it's built around that concept. So where COVID-19 comes in and the amount of, and the requirement, God forbid, the requirement is for sophisticated treatment, you know, whether at government hospitals or at private, you know, healthcare, in private healthcare. Health insurance policy is supposed to be the best policy for that. So ESIC may be difficult to get, and it may not have enough. The whole idea was it may not have, you know, it's not geared to treat COVID-19 cases. So you know, corporates which would, or small SMEs which would need to, are still have workers ACIC, I would recommend that they take a supplementary kind of coverage for you know, health insurance.
So one more thing that I've been noticing is that IRD has become very active in these days, and they have been issuing various circulars to insurance companies. I believe one circular that has been issued, Sanjay, is regarding the cashless claims, that cashless approvals and claims need to be settled in a very short period of time. So would you like to throw light on that?
So I think the guidelines, they have said that you have to, you know, give our approvals within 2 hours. That's the guideline which has come. So there are two types of, you know, issues. One is customer facing issues where the guideline has come, where hospitals send us, you know, kind of, you know, request for cashless facility, we should be able to complete the entire process, which is queries or whatever it is, our own due diligence, and be able to give it fast, which basically requires two things. One is cooperation on the hospital side in terms of the data they give us, and B, of course, our own efficiency in being able to give it. Amitabh has already talked about the way we have, you know, geared to do it, even from a out of the office kind of situation. And last but not the least, the whole issue of customers, you know, issue in terms of being able to identify a customer and all that. Of course, you know, I would might like to make an appeal here, either in terms of corporate customers who have health insurance with us, you know, giving data of the, about the customer, getting them enrolled, you know, without any delay is the most important part. Otherwise, it will get delayed, you know, because we'll not be able to find that customer on the list, and it, there is a whole loop in getting him registered with us. But apart from that, there is also another element of pressure which is coming in. So, you know, the issue is to settle all the bills of the hospitals fast so that they have enough money to be able to treat COVID-19 cases, which is, you know, once you give the cashless, then the, you know, the bill for that comes to us, and our ability to settle that is also very, very important. That will keep the liquidity in the system flowing. So we, you know, as a company have been, you know, trying to, you know, work with every hospital, you know, trying to, you know, use a e-claim facility with them to be able to register their, you know, bills, and we get that out fast. And last but not the least, I think the regulatory intervention is around coverage, and also for any retail policy which could not get renewed during the lockdown, you know, they have given regulatory forbearance for coming and getting it renewed, you know, on a post facto basis and getting your claims paid even in such a case.
So now, before I close, Sanjay and Amitabh, is there anything that you would like to say that I might have missed out in asking you, some changes, some things that we have done?
Amitabh first, then I'll add to that.
No, I think you covered all the points, and I just would like to end by saying that you know, we've created this facility, this app, you know, that we discussed, the I'll Take Care app. It's solution for our customers, for all the employees out there who, you know, can avail of our services. I would appeal at this forum that they try it out, use it, give us feedback so that we can keep making it better, make it more feature rich, and as well make it as seamless as possible.
And so, you know, the only thing I'd like to add to that is health insurance is something, you know, in India has, you know, got developed as a curative kind of remedy. You know, when you go to a hospital, only then, you know, would you need a kind of a health insurance. I think the way we are trying to move the entire thought process is that the biggest thing which is important for any customer is to make sure that he is, you know, doesn't use a hospital. You know, we do not want to go to, even now, who would want to go for normal, any kind of planned hospitalization now in this kind of state? I don't want to go to a hospital for various, for the obvious reasons. So then how do we take care of ourselves in these kind of, you know, times where we are able to maintain our whole, you know, health, both on a long-term and a short-term basis? That's where, you know, our ability to keep testing ourselves, you know, whether it's through medical tests, which we cover through I'll Take Care. So keep testing ourselves medically so that we are deemed to be fit. We have standards, we have access to, you know, a lot of doctors. And it is not, and look at how do we, you know, kind of keep preventing any health episodes. So that does include, and I would like to be very, very clear at this point, of we would as a company like to encourage use of all kinds of, you know, systems, whether of the alternate medicine side or the thing which includes wellness and, you know, homeopathy, Ayurveda, anything on diet and all of that, the whole gamut of experience to make sure that you do not have a health episode. The whole idea is to make sure that we do not. And that's what we are trying to encourage through the use of that app as one part. Also, get a host of measures. And one of the key critical factors when we found in corporate that we can't do this journey alone as an insurer. It requires a certain amount of, you know, responsibility of the corporate. Now that in this new normal, we as corporates have been asked to make sure that employees are safe through social distancing, maybe some work from home, maybe sanitizing our office and all that. That's a health initiative, you know, which the corporates are consciously taking. So I would recommend that when we follow that in the long term, as we, you know, come out of COVID, we also be a bit more directive on health, you know, the employees being, you know, much more health conscious and, you know, making sure that they take care of their health. rather than just leaving it to buying a health insurance where they get into a hospital, get treated. That's my limited kind of thought process.
So thank you, Sanjay. Thank you, Amitabh. And before closing, let me tell you that if you have liked this webinar, please let us know. And if there are any suggestions for future webinars, we will be coming up with a series of webinars based on your feedback. So maybe in a frequency of week or 10 days, we'll come up with another webinar. And if you want it to be on a particular topic, please let us know. Thanks a lot and have a good evening.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you and stay safe.
Stay safe.